More of a serious subject to start this show. As some of you may have seen over the weekend, the St. Louis Rams, you know, kind of entered the pregame warmups, hands up, kind of showing some solidarity for what happened, you know, in Ferguson, Missouri. Now, the St. Louis Police Officers Association, they pretty much condemned the Rams for the act, you know, kind of thought it was distasteful and kind of, you know, stirring things in the city of Ferguson and Missouri as a whole. Marvin, your thoughts on what the Rams receiving corps did there?
You know, I think the police department in St. Louis and in Ferguson has gone crazy. For them to condemn those players to having a peaceful protest and them showing solidarity, coming up with their hands up, I think it's absolutely outrageous and ridiculous. As an American, you have your First Amendment rights. You have the right to a peaceful protest. You have the right of freedom of speech. So for them to come out and do that and respect and to pay homage to the things that's happened in Ferguson because they are a pillar of their community since mm-hmm. they're right there, I think it's absolutely ridiculous for the police department to not only say they should be fined, but they also should be fired from the profession too as well.
Mm-hmm. Now, they are saying that they felt it was kind of, you know, two-faced because the Rams spent all week speaking with them, trying to make sure that things stay peaceful heading into the games. And obviously, you know, the verdict is in, you know, Officer Darren Wilson will not be indicted. And based on the evidence, you know, that's kind of presented, they feel that, you know, it's out there and that it's pretty conclusive. But I mean, it's like you said, you know, First Amendment rights, no matter what happens, you know, it's part of our rights as citizens. And I mean, another issue that needs to be spoken on, we see a lot of athletes out here that these kids and other guys are kind of looking up to when we say, when will they chime in on this issue? When will they, you know, chime in on that issue? And so for them to kind of show solidarity for the city of Ferguson, especially, you know, for a community of people that look just like them, I think, you know, it speaks volumes there.
I mean, what you also got to look at, too, is you also got to look at who's making these remarks. And for Jeff Rota, who's the head business manager of the police department, St. Louis Police Department, he has made a lot of questionable decisions in his past. So he has a shady past, per se. 2001, he was fired for misconduct. For filing misfiling police reports. Then the police department is saying that the Rams called them and issued an apology, but the head PR person for the Rams came out and said, no, that was not true at all. But there's a silver lining in this, and that is athletes are stepping up into the forefront of social issues that's going on, which is a great sight, which is bringing more attention about what's happening, because I felt that eventually the issues that's happened in Ferguson, the issues that's happened around in St. Louis would eventually die down. But as you can see, you know, with this happening, I think it's going to continue on for a long period of time moving forward. Mm-hmm.
And you touched on athletes, Marv, kind of stepping up and kind of showing kind of where they stand. How can anyone forget the photo of the Miami Heat after the during the Trayvon Martin saga?
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
With their hoodies up, you know, kind of showing that, you know, after he was gunned down by George Zimmerman there. How can one forget kind of things like that? LeBron James, just in terms of the whole Sterling situation, you really come to the forefront saying this is unacceptable. We can't have someone like that in our league. So rather than people that, you know, we kind of see as kind of take checks, go on about their business and their nice houses and their big cars and not really caring about the community, it's nice to see them kind of investing and showing, you know, their opinions on what's going on in and around them.
You know what, it's also a good opportunity for the NFLPA and the NFL Executive Association and Roger Goodell, that's been in hot water, which we'll touch on a little bit later, for him to stand behind his players. Because let's say that he goes and supports the police department. What is the message that you're really sending to the NFLPA? What is the message that you send to the rest of the athletes that's in the sport in NFL? I mean, sports is used to make a point. You know, it's always a microcosm of what's happening on in the real world. And it's, like we touched on before, it's great to see African-American athletes in their communities, the teams that they're playing for, step up and make a stand and show their true colors and show which line they're on. Either they're for what happened in Ferguson or they're against it. I'm glad that they stepped up and finally made a decision, you know, which is very positive.